As I mentioned, signaling is used between ATM devices, but we did not talk about why. Ethernet doesn't use signaling, so why is signaling required with ATM? Well, here's the difference. Ethernet is essentially connectionless, and ATM is connection-oriented. When you send an Ethernet packet, you are not required to first establish an end-to-end connection. You just send it. ATM, on the other hand, requires the connection to be established first. I'll illustrate this point with an example. Ethernet acts like the U.S. mail. There is no end-to-end connection established. You just send a letter and hope that it gets to its destination. And Ethernet switches, just like mailboxes, don't need to talk to each other. ATM, in contrast, acts more like the telephone. Before you can communicate, you need to dial the remote phone number. Then your phone signals its local phone switch, which then signals another, then another, until the remote phone is contacted. This communication between telephone devices is called signaling and operates just like ATM data devices do. So, just as when you make a phone call, when you communicate with ATM, you must first establish a connection with the destination. So how does ATM signaling work? When you want to communicate from your PC, ATM signals the local switch and requests a connection with the remote device you are trying to contact. The remote device's ATM address is included in the message. The local switch signals other switches along the path to the destination. Each switch in line establishes a connection and signals the next switch. Finally, the last switch connects to the remote destination and a connection is set up. Once the remote device is contacted, a connection signal is returned to the originating device. This serves as the connection acknowledgement, and now communication can occur. This one connection can support communication in both directions. Let me sum all this up quickly. The connection from the user's computer uses UNI signaling. The first switch converts the message into NNI signaling for all switch-to-switch signaling, and the final switch responds using UNI signaling for the last segment to the destination computer. In reality, this is almost identical to how a phone works. Why? Because ATM was developed by the telephone industry.